My man, Calhoun, Chip Tracy, Valley Sports South. There goes the Caniacs. They're in full force. PNC Arena. Freddie's back. Freddie's the go-to guy. He's the main guy for the Canes. The Hurricanes have been just a tad tardy. Good. Ron's has a good go at it, but Freddie is the man. He's the main guy. Jarvis! Oh! And DeCord will
make the save. He just had to have a couple really good steps because he was stationary. This good look from Aho to even gain separate. Then he was a little bit handcuffed in his release. DeCord recognized probably that he mishandled it slightly.
And Slavin's shot blocked in the slot. And Justin Williams told me you don't pick your nickname picks you. As Everly with a backhander.
Freddie! And guess what? Sharks taking her game tomorrow, which we'll be watching that one.
Very true. I remember more on this in a minute.
There's
an opportunity now for
Bjorkstrand
trying to shimmy shake it.
Whoa!
A little shoulder.
Crazy.
Burns, it goes upper 90, and Seattle grabs the lead 1-0.
And when you're in any process of changing, now Seattle was changing and they did so cleanly. Just have to make sure to get that puck deep at the offensive blue line. And I mean, just a super move. I mean, it's stopping and starting. The game is about stopping and starting. The way that Bjorkstrand stopped, gained separation, and the interior.
Jarvis will drop this one back for Aho. He'll spin, settle. Trying to get a shot was Lemieux, but he got his pocket picked by Bjorkstrand, and he'll pull up. Now he'll settle one, and he'll come in short. Goes through the
five. Whoa! Wow! Keeper Freddie! Holy mackerel!
5-hole through Anderson, and it's a 2-0 Kraken lead.
And made a play. And this thereafter leads to him flying the zone, knocking a puck out of midair, and settling it on his take. He had just started his shift on time, then flies the zone. Puck was on edge and still is able to open up Anderson.
Orlov heads to the bench, Chatfield's on, and now Shore got his first of the year, snaps his shot.
Freddie!
Top of his blue paint, Anderson makes the save and hangs on.
Watch this play here, good board play from Seattle. See the sag? When Carolina is dialed in to...
I saw Central, the fifth is Central, yo, 3-3. They're home tonight.
Kanyemi keeps it in again, Bunning. Pulling that around Schultz, and DeCord will play, and now Carolina comes up with a steal. So Kanyemi, side of the net, around for Bunning for Natchez.
Natchez!
Did the hard work, and Carolina on the board. It's 2-1. Marty Natchez with a loose change.
Clutch late third periods and overtimes last year. Gilbert blew a tire. The court was indecisive, indirected it to him. And Gilbert went heels to the ice. That allowed you to use the back of the net, and eventually Natchez gets on the attacking side of the puck. Bunting finds it. And with fight, he gives Carolina life. And Carolina gets a late period goal, not giving up one like they have recently.
Exactly, Apollo 3 teaching Rocky how to get back after it against Clever Lang. But it's those team-building moments. And somebody who knows how to throw hands, and Brendan Lemieux and Jack Drury seeking that advice that happened yesterday at practice. As the second period's underway. Tonight's officials, Carter Sandlack and Brian Pockmara, have not had a lot.
PNC Arena, Raleigh, North Carolina.
You know, it's trended. There weren't a ton of penalties.
Play-by-play, Mike Mascalo. Court analyst, Chip Tracy.
These are the two officials.
Resigned Hannah Yates, analyst, Shane Willis.
The momentum going is Jarvis.
Oh, man.
The court makes the save.
Starting to get itself going. They're reading and reacting off of one another. Dunner's been very good. Stripped of the puck by Aho. Jarvis might have wanted to get that to the net a little quicker, but it was bouncing. So he had to settle it.
Aho giving chase, taking a peek. He saw that he has Teravainen. Teravainen back to Aho. He'll have a low wrister that's handled by DeCord. He'll keep it moving for Alexiak, who almost gave it away. He'll get help knocked out by Winberg.
Tampa Bay Buffalo. I'll tell you who won that game. The Buffalo Bills did. But it was a close one, though. Baker Mayfield was a scrub, but Josh Allen was much better in that game.
They connected for that Canes goal late in the first period. Now a chance up front.
Ding dong! Ding dong, though. Like Butch Gus says.
Both defensemen caught below the goal line. Veneer says everything right. Uses the flex on his stick. It catches the post.
Is that really?
All right.
Use the puck to Burns, who will back in this, but can't clear. Veneer's now sent down low.
Oh, Freddy!
He enters the matrix on this save on Cartier.
Yeah, blocker save by Freddy.
To that home plate first.
All right, here we go. Third period.
You're going to have success.
I love how that graphic illustrates where it's coming from. And again, you want to see more in that. It's just called it home plate area. As the Canes work the puck in, Jarvis. Back around for Tara Biden. Back around for Jarvis. As this line starts this third period. Burns shot is... He was swinging for the fences, but DeCord comes up with a...
Joey DeCord!
...try to strip of the puck like Stahl did, but DeCord used his big frame on the Hurricanes.
Dave Haxall must be feel comfortable about it, starting Joey, because he's been playing a lot lately. Philip Grubauer is usually the guy, but Joey DeCord has been good. Keep in mind, Joey DeCord at Coachella get to the finals in AHL.
Escape deflecting out front. Seattle just flings this out of the zone, hanging on for dear life.
I'm glad they got rid of Martin. Martin is a freaking dud.
Who's got Jarvis with him? Aho tries to go.
Oh!
It's a 2-on-1. Heck of a job by denying the passing line by Morgan. But he's trying to make DeCord think that he's going, trying to go for Sauce.
Yeah, just saying, Joe was in an AHL Coachella a lot last year.
Angelo with it. Drive that's blocked away by DeCord. Drury keeping it rolling. It'll come free. Devin Shore, who right now has the marker that's standing as the go-ahead goal for the Seattle team. It made it 2-0. It's 2-1 score now.
I'm glad Broad is giving Anderson more chance. He needs it because he's the guy.
He was at the end of his shift. He needs to head to the bench. He will. Seattle gets the puck in the game zone. Shore will slide it.
Oh, Freddy. I think he got a piece of that one.
Zone drop for Everly. Everly trying to get it back. But Brady Shea with a stellar defensive play. Now Shea, he's got his motor going.
Look at Shea.
Backhand across. Natchez drops it back. They score! Yes, Barry Kotkaniemi ties it in 2.
Brady Shea desperately makes the play, kicks it. Dorothy Wizard of Oz style from his left skate up to his tape. Eventually you have numbers. Heck of a pass, and Nate just makes an even better pass to Kotkaniemi on his offside. And in one motion, Kotkaniemi brings it on edge, almost harpoons it into the back of the net.
Can't get into the Kane zone. Karabinen will get to it. He'll roll this in deep. 28 seconds left. Aho and Dunn go after it. Aho does a good job to get it to Jarvis. Karabinen burns his shot. That block doesn't get through.
Graham Burns.
As Everly got in front of that try. Shea all the way in his own end. He's bothered by Everly. 13 seconds left here in regulation. 2-2 game. Seattle with the first two of this one. Carolina with the last two. Now Everly, with time winding down, just throws one towards Anderson's net. That misses everything, and we've got bonus hockey coming in.
Overtime's coming up.
There are the two defensemen.
All right, ready, let's go.
Burns and Stahl wins it.
Who's going to get the extra point?
Burns off the boards for
Kraken. King's got one.
Getting the stick into McCann. 30 seconds left here in overtime. McCann gets through. Anderson makes the
Freddy!
Burns clears it out to Aho.
He had the old reach around, Freddy did. He wasn't sure if he had it.
Well, he grabbed it, and now Natchez with it.
Okay.
Natchez sends it across D'Angelo. Holding back across Natchez. White scores!
Natchez!